Hello mga besh! Welcome back to my channel. Ito ulit ang inyong lingkod na si Mercy na bumabati sa inyo ng isang magandang araw po sa inyong lahat dyan. So mga besh, kung hindi ka pa nag-subscribe, please don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell para ma-update ka sa mga upcoming vlogs natin like this. So ayan mga besh, today we're going to talk about mealybugs, about the causes, prevention, and also some ways on how to get rid of these mealybugs. So if you're ready, kindly watch this video until the end. So mealybugs are related to scale insects. They cause damage by sucking the juice from their host plant. Like many other pests, mealybugs tend to favor new growth. Over time, their damage causes the leaves to yellow and eventually drop the plants. They can also cause fruits, vegetables, and flower buds to prematurely drop off. So In a bad infestation, their waxy excretion, or also known as honeydew, encourages the development of sooty-like fungus. Mealybugs are sometimes difficult insect to control because of their habit of feeding in secluded parts of the plants. The first thing you might notice is sooty mold building up. Keep an eye out for sooty mold while you are watering your plants. So if you find sooty mold, then you should see if you can find what it causes. Mealybugs often, the first sign of having mealybugs in your plants is the sooty mold. Prevention is better than cure. The only way mealybug can get into your garden or your house is on a plant. Check plant and cuttings for mealybugs before bringing them into your garden or into your house, especially when you're buying new plants, new succulents, and you bring them inside your home together with your other plants, house plants or succulents. So before you mingle those plants with your houseplant and succulent, always check your plants from mealybugs or other insects. There are several things that you can do to prevent or minimize mealybugs damage. A trick is to not let them build up. And regular monitoring of your plants, either indoor or outdoor garden, will ensure that major infestation of mealybug doesn't occur overnight. Managing mealybug is much easier if you can catch an infestation in its early stages. Don't wait for an infestation to build up to unmanageable levels. To treat mealybugs indoors and outdoors, I got some treats and tricks. So, here's my way on how to get rid of mealybugs on my plants. First, wash mealybugs away. Mealybugs can be dislodged with a steady stream of water. Repeat the treatment as necessary. This is the best for light infestation only and for other plants who cannot tolerate other treatment. Next, second is use an isopropyl alcohol. Soak a cotton with regular rubbing alcohol and wipe it on the mealybugs, which will both kill and remove them. Use alcohol consisting of no more than 70% isopropyl alcohol and test it on the leaf before you apply it on the whole plant to make sure the alcohol doesn't burn it. Next, spray with insecticidal soap. Insecticidal soaps are available on the market. Try to find a product free from fumes and additives that might harm your plant. Mix the soap in a weak concentration with water, so starting at 1 teaspoon per gallon and increasing as necessary. Spray the soapy solution on plants. Next, use neem oil. Neem oil is a natural substance derived from a neem tree. In addition to its insecticidal properties, neem oil is also a fungicide, which used as directed, it is only kill insects on contact, but serves as a synthetic pesticide by being absorbed into the plant. According to Environmental Protection Agency, neem oil is safe to use on vegetables and other edible plants as well as ornamentals. Next, introduce predatory insects. Lace insects, lace wings, parasitic wasps, and beetle, sometimes known as the mealybug destroyer, are natural predators of mealybugs. These are more commonly used for outdoor infestation or in the greenhouse situation and are available for commercial online retailers. Next, use homemade insect spray. So, this one is quite effective, my bash. To make a batch of homemade insect spray, combine 1 garlic bulb, 1 small onion, and 1 teaspoon of cayenne pepper in a food processor or blender and process into a paste. Mix into 1 quart of water and step for 1 hour. So after 1 hour, strain through a chest cloth and add 1 tablespoon of liquid dish soap. Mix well, and then the mixture can be stored up to 1 week in the refrigerator. Spray the solution on the plant parts where mealybugs are present. The last one is synthetic chemical pesticides, or the one that we bought from the store. So, a number of stronger insecticides are approved for the use against mealybugs, but be cautious when you're using these chemicals, especially in indoor location. Strong pesticides have varying degrees of toxicity to pets and humans. How to use this synthetic chemical pesticide? Just see the description of the pesticides that you're using on how to use it properly. How long do mealybugs live? Female mealybugs lay from 200 to 600 eggs, which hatch in a few days. Within 6 to 10 weeks, the hatch insects are ready to lay their own eggs. So, they are so quick, mga besh. So, an infestation of mealybugs can perpetuate itself almost indefinitely unless they are eradicated. That's why we need to make sure we get rid of this mealybug as soon as we get we see them or we catch them in our plants, so we can avoid severe infestation in our garden. Do mealybugs bite or sting? So, mealybug do not pose any danger of biting or stinging humans. They only feed on juices of plants. So, they only harm our plants and other they only harm plants and also, example, our ornamental plants, our ender plants, and also our succulents, even our fruit-bearing plants. So, what plants are most susceptible? So, there are so many species of mealybugs that almost any ender plant can be susceptible to this pest. In particular, tropical plants with softer stem and leaves are very likely to develop mealybugs. Orchids, begonias, coleus, and other soft plants, and even succulents, are among plants also to be especially susceptible. But in warmer climates, many outdoor plants are likely to experience infestation as well. Mealybugs thrive in temperature between 70 to 90 degrees Fahrenheit. So, ayan mga besh, mealybugs really like warm environment. So, ayan mga besh, yan po ang ating mga tips and tricks and also some facts about mealybugs. So, kung nagustuhan nyo tong content natin today, please hit like and also share it with your friends para makita din nila on how we get rid of mealybugs in our garden. So, if you are still not subscribed, kindly hit the subscribe button and also the notification bell para ma-update ka on our upcoming vlogs like this. So, ayan mga besh, bye-bye for now. I'll see you next time.